SQL versus NoSQL. You'll be surprised to know that this conversation comes up more than often than you think. Hello, my name is Jamil Spain, Brand Technical Specialist with the U.S. Financial Services Market. And as you try to pick a side on how you want to choose to use SQL or NoSQL databases, I thought it would be great for me to bring out my top five differences to really give you the information you want to back up your decision. So let's get started with this. When it comes to SQL, we know that this works off a relational database structure here. Now that means that you're gonna access all your data points. They have to have some type of relation. You gotta do a lot of pre-work to kind of decide out your structure, how they're gonna relate. Whereas on the NoSQL side, this is not relational, so we really don't have to. I really feel for a lot of projects, I can go ahead and get started and deal with a lot of that effort later on in the process here. As your database channel checks, gets a lot of traffic and needs to really start to grow, on the infrastructure for SQL servers, they're gonna vertically scale. Okay, whereas on the NoSQL side, these are gonna be horizontal scaling. All right, and we know that SQL servers are gonna be backed by disks. They're gonna need more memory, more computing power to actually process all these transactions, whereas horizontally with NoSQL, it's all in memory. I can keep adding secondary nodes to handle and balance out a lot of the usage there as well. On the SQL side, when I kind of talk about my structure, it's really gonna be always about table, being table-based. I am super concerned about how I'm categorizing my entities, my tables into records, and how I'm doing my relationships. So I have to kind of think of more of a warehouse kind of nature that I'm collecting all this data here as well. And we all know from NoSQL, it is based on a document approach. So these are really gonna be documents. All right, they can be key value hashes. This is great for GraphQL. I mean, a lot of the graphs, okay, it's really meant to not really have any kind of structure. It's kind of the opposite of being a table base. I can fit pretty much anything in there as well. So what about when you want to access all the data? I'm gonna have to use the SQL query language to actually define all my queries, to pull all my data out. So it's kind of some pre-planning about how I'm gonna access and join my data, if I'm gonna normalize all the data there. Where I feel the NoSQL is definitely much, much more dynamic, all right? I'm really able to really just make my collections of these type of documents no matter what the structure, and then I can have more freedom to let it flow and how I want to query these items as well. So lastly, SQL, great for multi-row transactions, where we have our tables, we have a lot of data that we want to put in. Remember the ability to do the transactions and being able to roll back and forth. So I can really control a lot of what goes in. On the other side with NoSQL, we remember that this is going to be all unstructured. Usually it's JSON. It's very great for working with JSON. Let me make sure I write here number four. That was also dynamic. All right, so be unstructured JSON versus something that is very planned out. I specifically want to enter this in as well. So that kind of ends the features between the two, but actually, I can think of a scenario where this actually is an that should be here as well. Do we really have to make a definitive choice of either or? One of those scenarios goes to the fact that I can have, let's say I have a common e-commerce application, which is usually composed of some bit of mobile and has some interaction with a more of a backend, whether it's an API that wants to kind of go, we want to commit a lot of the data. Think about a shopping cart. Okay, let's kind of visualize this for a minute. As I make sessions, I browse, I do all these things. It's more like data in transient. It's not really ready to be committed yet. So I could see unstructured session data, product data, what I clicked on, set of clicks, all that stuff could be great for compiling into any structure into a NoSQL side. And then as I make the order or the transaction, that could be definitely something that I kick off into my SQL database back in, where I want to facilitate interaction with different departments. Not only is it going to the shipping department, maybe the marketing, maybe a couple other subsystems that I want to document that an order has been placed and kick off a few other work streams. So this is just one of many scenarios that you can choose. I'll be curious to know in the future whether you pick a side or you join forces to power your next application. Thank you for your time.
If you have questions, please drop us a line below. And if you want to see more videos like this in the future, please like and subscribe.